In this tutorial, we'll explore the benefits of using top and bottom tab navigators and provide step-by-step instructions on implementation. Top or bottom tab navigators are a row of tabs placed at the top or bottom of the screen, allowing users to switch between different screens with a simple tap. Let's start with why you might choose to use a top or bottom tab navigator. By incorporating a top or bottom tab navigator, you enhance discoverability. Users can quickly identify and access different sections of your app, which ensures that they can find what they're looking for effortlessly. A top or bottom tab navigator enables seamless switching between sections. This fluid user experience keeps users engaged and satisfied with your app. With a top or bottom tab navigator, you have the freedom to customize the appearance of each tab to match your app's branding and unique requirements. Now that we understand the benefits, let's discuss how to implement a top or bottom tab navigator in your Thunkable app. To add a navigator to your app, click the drop-down arrow at the top of your component tree. Hover over Add Navigator and select either the top or bottom tab navigator. We'll demonstrate the top tab navigator, but the instructions remain the same for the bottom tab navigator. Under the top tab navigator in the component tree, there are four nested screens. These reflect the app's navigation tabs. By default, the navigator includes four tabs. You'll need to identify the sections or views you want to include in your app and add or remove tabs accordingly. To add an additional tab to your navigator, create a new screen and, within the component tree, drag it to nest within the tab navigator component. To remove a tab, delete its corresponding screen in the component tree. Let's check out how you can customize your navigator. Click on the tab navigator in the component tree to access the navigator's properties panel. Here on the right side, you can customize the properties specific to the navigator. For example, you can customize the navigator's visual design by changing the navigator's background color. The tab indicator is a line that signals the active tab. You can customize its color. Active tint color adjusts the text color for the tab the user is currently engaging with, and inactive tint color adjusts the text color for the tabs the user is not engaging with. Now let's explore some of the tab-specific properties. Select a screen in the component tree or at the top of your project. Change the text in the tab using the tab bar label field. By default, each tab has an associated icon, but you can upload your own custom icons to align with your brand. You can even customize the inactive tab icon if you'd like. We'll add a map component to the screen for demonstration purposes. We'll save working with the map component for another tutorial and simply stick with the default component image for this tutorial. Let's check out our navigator in the web preview. Looking good! Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to check out our other tutorials and Thunkable Academy courses. And remember, if you can think it, you can thunk it.